This is the first part of the tutorial series where we make a low-poly vehicle for Unreal Engine 4. Link in the description to see the result of the completed tutorial series. Start with a new Blender project and delete everything from it. Set the scene unit scale to 0.01 and increase clip end distance. Add cube mesh and change its dimensions to 2.9 meters on x-axis, 1.45 meters on y-axis, 0.1 meters on z-axis. Enter edit mode and add two loop cuts. Select top face which is located at a negative x-axis side, and extrude it upwards 0.7 meters. Select extruded face's edge which is located towards mesh center and move it minus 0.1 meters in x-axis. Select a front face of the base and scale it by 0.7 on y-axis. Select a front top face and extrude it upwards 0.55 meters. Lower front edge by 0.3 meters. Select front side edges and bevel them by 0.3. Add path. Set path bevel depth to 0.05 meters and order U to 2. Enter edit mode and delete one end vertice. Now we will place each vertice by changing its global coordinates. Set the first vertice coordinate to x 0.6 meters, y 0.6 meters, z 0.5 meters. Second vertice to x 0.2 meters, y 0.55 meters, z 1.4 meters. Third to x minus 1 meter, y 0.55 meters, z 1.6 meters. Fourth to x minus 1.4 meters, y 0.65 meters, z 0.7 meters. Set transform pivot point to 3D cursor. Duplicate the tube and scale it by minus 1 on y axis. Add another path. Rotate it by 90 degrees on z-axis. Move it to minus 0.99 meters on x-axis and 1.57 meters on z-axis. In the edit mode, delete side vertices until you have two left. Set one vertice Y position to 0.55 meters and another vertice Y position to minus 0.55 meters. Set path bevel depth to 0.04 meters. Go into the object mode and duplicate path and then move it to 0.19 meters on X-axis and 1.39 meters on Z-axis. Select all paths and convert them to meshes, then join meshes to the base mesh. Add cube mesh and change its dimensions to 0.05 meters on y-axis. Enter edit mode and enable X-ray. Enable snapping, and in the snapping settings set snap to edge. Snap in cube's outer short edges into the vehicle base by moving them in the X and Z axis. Switch to the object mode and snap door mesh to the base mesh side. Add another cube and change its dimensions to 0.15 meters on x-axis, 0.02 meters on y-axis, 0.02 meters on z-axis. Enable snapping to face and move handle mesh on the door mesh. Move handle to minus 0.35 meters on x-axis and 0.6 meters on z-axis. Join handle mesh to the door mesh. Make sure that the transform pivot point is set to the 3D cursor and the 3D cursor is in its default position. Duplicate the door and scale it by minus 1 on y-axis. Join door meshes to the base mesh. Hide the base mesh, and then add cube mesh and change its dimensions to 0.5 meters on x-axis, 0.5 meters on y-axis, 0.4 meters on z-axis. Enter edit mode and add loop cut, and then move it by minus 0.1 in x-axis. Select a smallest top face and extrude it upwards 0.45 meters. Then move it by minus 0.1 meters in x-axis. Go into object mode and unhide base mesh. Then set seat mesh location to minus 0.2 meters on x-axis, 0.3 meters on y-axis, 0.25 meters on z-axis. Make sure that the transform pivot point is set to the 3D cursor and the 3D cursor is in its default position. Duplicate the seat and scale it by minus 1 on y-axis, and then join seat meshes to the base mesh. Hide the base mesh, and then add cylinder mesh and set its radius to 0.02 meters and depth to 0.5 meters. Add a cube and change its dimensions to 0.2 meters on x-axis, 0.3 meters on y-axis, 0.02 meters on z-axis. Apply scale to the cube, and then in the edit mode bevel short edges by 0.05. In the object mode move cube part over the cylinder part. Then enable snapping to face. And snap cube part to the cylinder top face. Join the cube part to the cylinder part and unhide the base mesh. Set steering wheel mesh location to 0.4 meters on x-axis, 0.3 meters on y-axis, 0.5 meters on z-axis and its y rotation to minus 45 degrees. Join the steering wheel to the base mesh. Add a cylinder mesh and set its radius to 0.1 meters and depth to 0.03 meters. Then set mesh Y rotation to 90 degrees, and location to 0.47 meters on X-axis, 0 meters on Y-axis, 0.49 meters on Z-axis. Join mesh to the base mesh. Add another cylinder mesh and set its radius to 0.07 meters and depth to 0.03 meters. Then set mesh Y rotation to 90 degrees, and location to 0.47 meters on X-axis, 0.57 meters on Y-axis, 0.49 meters on Z-axis. Join mesh to the base mesh. Add a cube and change its dimensions to 0.02 meters on x-axis, 0.3 meters on y-axis, 0.15 meters on z-axis. Then set its location to minus 1.46 meters on x-axis, 0.4 meters on y-axis, 0.55 meters on z-axis. Duplicate the mesh and scale it by minus 1 on y-axis, and then join meshes to the base mesh. Add another cube and change its dimensions to 0.02 meters on x-axis, 0.1 meters on y-axis, 0.15 meters on z-axis. Then set its location to minus 1.46 meters on x-axis, 0.4 meters on y-axis, 0.61 meters on z-axis. Duplicate the mesh and scale it by minus 1 on y-axis, and then join meshes to the base mesh. Hide the base mesh, and then add UV sphere mesh and set its radius to 0.1 meters. Switch to top orthographic view, enable X-ray and with the box select tool select sphere half which is faced towards positive x-axis. Delete selected faces. Select sphere opening edges and fill the selection with a face. Select 2x8 faces on the positive y-axis side of the half sphere. Extrude faces by 0.05 meters. Select edges like shown in the video. Mark selected edges as a seam. Go into object mode and unhide base mesh. Then set front light mesh location to 1.5 meters on x-axis, 0.3 meters on y-axis, 0.2 meters on z-axis. Make sure that the transform pivot point is set to the 3D cursor and the 3D cursor is in its default position. Duplicate the mesh and scale it by minus 1 on y-axis, and then join meshes to the base mesh. Hide the base mesh, and then add cube mesh and change its dimensions to 0.15 meters on x-axis, 0.5 meters on y-axis, 0.15 meters on z-axis. Enter edit mode and select face which faces towards negative y-axis and move it up by 0.2 meters. Go into object mode and unhide base mesh. Then set axle mesh location to minus 1.1 meters on x-axis, 0.95 meters on y-axis, minus 0.1 meters on z-axis. Duplicate the axle and set a new axle location to 0.95 meters on x-axis, 0.8 meters on y-axis, minus 0.1 meters on z-axis. Make sure that the transform pivot point is set to the 3D cursor and the 3D cursor is in its default position. Select both axles and duplicate them. Then scale them by minus 1 on y-axis, and then join meshes to the base mesh. Hide the base mesh, and then add cylinder mesh and set its radius to 0.4 meters and depth to 0.35 meters. Rotate mesh by 90 degrees in x-axis. Go into edit mode and delete circle faces and bottom half of cylinder faces. Select side edges which are at the negative y-axis side and make a new face. Exit edit mode and add solidify modifier to the mesh. And set thickness to 0.01 meters. And then apply it to the mesh. Unhide base mesh. Then set mudguard mesh location to minus 1.1 meters on x-axis, 1.3 meters on y-axis, minus 0.1 meters on z-axis. Duplicate the mudguard and set a new mudguard location to 0.95 meters on x-axis, 1.15 meters on y-axis, minus 0.1 meters on z-axis. Make sure that the transform pivot point is set to the 3D cursor and the 3D cursor is in its default position. Select both mudguards and duplicate them. Then scale them by -1 on y-axis, and then join meshes to the base mesh. Set smooth shading to the mesh. Apply scale to the mesh. Enable auto smooth to the mesh and set its angle to 33 degrees. Enable face orientation in overlays. Go into edit mode and select all red mesh parts. Flip selected part normals. Subscribe to the channel so you would not miss further uploads.